Donuts. Get you donuts. Nice. We'll do it right in front of a cop. That's always good. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the first episode of American Truck Simulator. Today we're using a mod for a Kentworth W900 long. I'm really looking forward to that. Looks like a good truck. This is it right here, actually. It's got a lot of side lights on it. I've already gone through and done all the upgrades. The tanks are like 450 gallons a piece. It's a powerhouse. I think it's a 700 horsepower engine. And it's the 18 speed. We're also using couple other mods, traffic mods, realistic trailers, the longer yellow lights, obviously need more time in the intersection, and there's many more. I'll put them all in the description with the link, just so you guys can use it if you want. So let's go inside and take a look. Apparently my guy's tired as well. So this is the inside, the front. I've already aligned the mirrors. I've got the mirrors down in the front by the bumper. Looks like built-in navigation. It's got all the gauges, the switches. Tells you on the little dash what gear you're in. Two high, one high. Take a look to the back. It's got a TV, sink, microwave, little couch area. Turns into a bed. Leather jacket up there. Can actually go back here and sit down, look out the window. Looks like a some controls up there. Little mini fridge, freezer. I don't know what that is, either a DVD player or a laptop or something. Looks like some CDs there. So, looks like it's fully equipped. Little light on the wall. So, first off, I believe we're going to see what type of job we can do. We'll look for something that's kind of close, but not too short. This one here doesn't look too bad, but I'd like to get an actual decent trailer. Yeah, that's 370 miles. Maybe we'll go with something like this one here. Diesel, 42,500 pounds. Going from Los Angeles, California to Bakersfield, California. Looks like we're leaving. It expires in 10 hours, and they're expecting us on Saturday between 9:30 a.m. and 4:20 p.m. So we'll go ahead and do that. Alright, looks like the fuel is okay for now. Bring up the gauge here. Definitely need sleep, so we can go ahead and take care of that for now. This truck is so long, it's going to be tough to move and maneuver around these tight areas. Try not to hit anything in the back. It's very tough to judge that. Might just make that. Yes, we did. Okay. So, no one's coming here. Pull out. Wow, that's a very tight turn there. Alright, let's put some lights on as well so people can see us. Doesn't look like anyone's coming there. Might as well pull out. Looks like the speed limit's 30 miles an hour, so we'll go ahead and follow that. We gotta find a rest stop here at some point as well. I think we'll go ahead and we'll pick up the trailer. And then we'll find the nearest rest stop. I am using a steering wheel, pedals, and H-shifter. The steering wheel is actually a Thrustmaster. It's a Ferrari 458. Using the three-pedal setup, it's also a Thrustmaster. It's a T3 PA. And the H-shifter is a Thrustmaster TH8A. They do work very nice. I like that you can set everything up the way you want. Force feedback on them is excellent. The only issue I do run into every now and then with this game... Oh, that was a little wide. Only issue every now and then with this game is the feedback. You can turn the wheel about halfway, and then for whatever reason, it'll get very tough. Like, it's not linear. But you check all the settings, and everything seems to work out fine, so you unplug it, plug it back in, it works fine after that. Not every time, it's just an every now and then thing. Not sure how the microphone quality is on this right now. I'm hoping it's loud enough to where everybody can hear, but I do have another microphone coming in the mail, which I'll have for the next video. So we should be all set with that. Yeah, just so you know, the microphone that I got, bought it off Amazon, nothing special. It's coming with the filter and everything. It's the Blue Yeti. So hopefully that will work for us. Gotta get over in this lane. Should be there in about 10 minutes. Roughly 6 miles. Oh yeah, guy's starting to shut his eyelids. Got a little close to that guy. Not used to this long, extra long trailer. Or extra long truck, sorry. So we should be pulling in right up here on the right. I believe it said it was a diesel tanker, 42,500 pounds. Certainly won't be a problem with this truck, but I did use some of the default trucks, and some of them do need a little extra power. So let's go ahead and pick this up. I believe it's this one. Los Angeles to Bakersfield, that's the one. Let's go grab that over here. Not sure if it's... Yeah, it's in the back. Okay. You can almost skip a gear on this one. It's so low. It just... You get like 2 or 3 miles an hour and you gotta shift again. Alright. Let's make the turn. That's ours right over there on the end. Go ahead and get lined up. Tough to see back there. Perfect. Let's go ahead and straighten it out. Let's do a little tug test with the trailer brakes, make sure everything's lined up. Looks like it is. Yep. Okay. So let's go ahead and take a hop out and look at it, make sure everything's all set up. definitely a long trailer. With the long truck, this is going to be a fun ride. Triple axle in the back. And let's see what the... yes, 42,500 pounds. Yes, I know I'm tired. We'll go take a nap. Next rest stop is in 28 minutes. So let's go ahead and get moving on this. Turn the parking brake off. This is going to be quite the turning. Now, I'm not sure what I'm going to do in the following episodes. Either we could use different trucks or use the same truck for a few different episodes and switch it. We can kind of play that by ear and see what everyone likes. I particularly like this truck. I know there's also an old-fashioned one that's out now. Sounds awesome. Oh, not what I wanted. Okay. No one's coming. Alright, so we gotta go try to find a rest stop. I'm not sure where there is one around. Oh, right over here on the left. I thought that was just a gas station. That works. Alright, let's go in the back. Looks like our fuel's good for now. We shouldn't need to worry about that. This isn't one that you pull in on the side. This one's just a straight-in shot. Alright. Let's go ahead and turn the engine off. And we'll go to sleep. Nope. I think I went past it just a little too far. There we go. That's what we wanted. So we'll go ahead and rest. Nice, fresh morning start. A little snow on the ground as well. I do have the mod on for the frost. Alright, let's start her up. Turn the parking brake off. I can't tell what's all the way back there. But we'll go ahead and stop there. We definitely have plenty of room. You can hear it in the shifting. It's just so fast and short. All right. So we want to take a left out of here. Looks like there's a car coming. We'll wait for him to pass by. All righty. One more over here on the left. Oh, couple more. Definitely have the traffic mod on. Alright, I think we're good. Let's go ahead and do this. Watch the trailer so we don't hit it on the exit. Shift up into 5 high. Let's turn that off so we can see. Missed that one. Alright, well, this is going to be fun getting out of. There's that FedEx trailer. That's part of the truck or the trailer mod that I added. Sometimes you just gotta inch your way out until they stop for you. There we go. Now they want to stop. Let's see if these guys stop for this white truck so we can get moving. We're not going to make it around him, that's for sure. Yep, pissing everybody off. It's the only way I would have made it. There's another big tanker over there. Oh, never mind. That's an open top. Here he goes. Looks like we have 137 miles to go, 3 hours and 34 minutes. I'm not exactly sure what the game time relates to in real time, but I know it's very short. 136 miles won't take us too long at all. Going a little over the speed limit there. We'll just follow this truck right in front of us. Going forward, I do play other games as well. It won't just be American Truck Simulator. We'll also do Counter-Strike, Dead by Daylight, My Summer Car, and possibly H1Z1. I'm not too sure about that game. I like it, but I just don't know if I want to get into recording that one and playing it, just because I do play that one a lot less than others. So. Another thing I noticed with this game is they have the track IR. It's kind of like a little camera that sits above top on top of your monitor, and you have the sensors on the brim of your hat, and it will kind of it'll monitor them to make sure, you know, if you look left, your screen will turn left instead of having to either use your mouse, or you can use the clickers like this to go back and forth, and then you got to recenter. So definitely an option to help make it smoother, I should say. I don't know if this is a red light up here or if he's just stopped looking and waiting for his turn. For some reason, I'm only getting 34 frames a second. I usually get much higher than that. I usually run this game with all three monitors, so I don't have to turn as much. Hey, a payphone. When's the last time you guys saw a payphone? Actually, I should say, when's the last time you guys saw a payphone that works? Come on, what do we got going on up there? Let's take a look. Oh yeah, there's no stoplight. We're just waiting for two trucks in front of us and two cars. This could be quite the wait. And we got quite the line behind us as well. Yep. Nice day out, though. You can definitely see the frost on the grass. Someone walking over there. That was a police car. Well, at this rate, We can just throw it in neutral, put on the parking brake, and go back here and, well, we got some Monster Energy drink. Couple on the table right there. It looks like there's Netflix on TV. Can't see any shows or anything. Oh yeah, that is a nice little air conditioning vent up there. I don't know what that is. I wonder if that's like a monitor for outside, or if it's just another monitor that duplicates that. But you can actually see out the window if cars go by, which is very cool. By the looks of it, traffic has not moved at all. Maybe one car width, or one car length. I'm not even sure if we moved. We can go ahead and move up a little bit. So what I'm thinking is I will go ahead and skip to the point where the traffic has moved forward and we can then move ahead. Because by the looks of it, we're going to be here for a while. Yep, we haven't moved at all. Two cars are still up there. You can hear the horn though. The horn sounds really cool. Let's see. That's very cool. Nice and loud and deep. But yeah, so I'll go ahead and skip ahead. And we will see how long this takes. Right now. And if it doesn't stop pretty soon, I'm just going to pull out. And we'll see if they stop then. Nice. We'll do it right in front of a cop. That's always good. We'll wait for after him. Okay. Stay there. Nice. This guy's going to stop for us. Looks like we're good to go now. Get rid of that. Center the field of view again. Well, that was a post-ed truck. I thought I updated all those so they'd line up together. Looks like a nice set of tennis courts over there. Playground for the kids. I do like the details in this game. I mean, as basic as it does look, I mean, you got kids over there skateboarding. Little skateboarding park. Actually, it was a big skateboarding park. Let's make sure we don't miss our turn, which is right here. Made that pretty nicely. Alright, so it looks like we have 131 miles, 3 hours and 25 minutes. I know we really haven't moved too much because we spent a little while sitting at that stop sign, I guess you'd call it. But that's alright. We will get there eventually. Brakes are very touchy too. Make sure we swing this. Perfect. Yeah, I'm not sure. I do like the. I mean, this truck has good sounds. It's sounds pretty realistic. The shifting's nice. But I do think I like the idea of switching up and using different trucks after, a couple episodes, or if I find a new mod that looks pretty good for a different truck model, then we'll go ahead and try that out. If anything, it gives everybody a idea of what's out there and if they're decent without having to go through the trouble of doing it yourself. Actually, we're gonna hop down to 7 high. Seems like we're going a little quick for this. Ooh, buddy. That was the exit for San Diego. We're gonna drop our speed here going around this corner. Down to 40. Once I get the track IR, it'll be a little smoother on the turns and everything. I won't have to use the mouse to move the whole screen left and right. This guy gonna let us over? Yes, he is. To be honest, he really didn't have a choice, so. Looks like we want Bakersfield, so we'll go over this way. That guy went around us just to go back into the same lane to take a right. Some people are very impatient. Just gonna go around him, but got a cop right there. Let's move over a lane and carry on. Sometimes you'll see me do that just to center the screen. It's easier than trying to do it with the mouse. Oh, this is a turn only. Just my luck. Looks like we're still good on fuel. Fuel's good. Yeah, we're good for the trip. Only got 90 miles to go. Earlier I said it was 450 gallons a piece for the tanks. It's not, it's 450 combined. But either way, it's plenty of fuel for any of the trips that we'll be doing for the most part. I mean, every now and then we'll do a long trip. I mean, we may do, a 700-mile trip, but I usually like to keep it between the 100 and 300 for the majority of the episodes, just so everybody can have a quick viewing of a truck or some other mod, if it's a traffic mod, a trailer mod or anything like that. So we can work on all that as we go. I don't know how much longer I'll keep the frostbite, or the not the frostbite, the frost mod in here. And starting to get to the point where we can go back to grass and get rid of the snow. If you live in New England, just got between 12 and 18 inches of snow, so I guess this wouldn't really make sense to get rid of the frost at this point, but I've had the frost in here for myself for a little while now, so I'd like to see something different. See if we can move over a lane and give people some room. There we go. Keep an eye on the trailer back there. Forgot it is a pretty long one. Way over the speed limit. We'll slow that down just a little bit. ahead and use the actually we're doing pretty good now. We shouldn't need to. Guess we can turn off all of our lights. We don't need those on anymore. Come on, buddy. What are you doing? Let's speed things up a little bit here. Thank you for letting me come over. I believe I also have the mod on, which doesn't let the cops give you tickets as often. I think you can go over the speed limit a little more without having to deal with a ticket every time you're going over by 4 or 5 miles an hour. Let's go ahead and shift up on that. So we got about 19 miles, which will be coming up pretty quick here. Getting off up here on the right. Get prepared for this turn. Installment from one of my garage workers. Alright, we're good. No one's coming. Let's hope we can swing this turn. Yep, no problems. Come on, let's shift. Alright. Speed limit's 30 miles an hour here. So make sure we watch that trailer back there and stay off the guardrail. And try to get over a lane. Perfect, no one's there. Looks like the destination is up here on the left. So we'll go ahead and get back over in the left lane. Actually, we're merging anyway, so that's fine. Doing here? Wonder what that is over there. Oh, it's another garage. Huh, we'll have to check that out. We'll drop off the trailer and come back and check that out and see what we got. That would be nice because my current garage is full. So if I could get a new one, that would really help us out. Donuts. Get your donuts. Hey, we're moving. Well, not too far. Looks like a little car dealership over there to the left. Oh. Let's get moving here. Yeah, I understand the, you know, the mic's a little high and then it's low at points. I'm using a Turtle Beach headset right now. The microphone's right there, so the Blue Yeti will definitely help. I can put that off on the table stay the same distance away, set it up, should be perfect. So we'll definitely try that out in the next video. Not sure if the next video is going to be another American Truck Simulator or if we want to go with a different game. If we do another one, it might be a My Summer Car episode. We'll start right from the beginning, build the engine, put the suspension in. We'll take a trip to the store so we can get some food and some drinks. And well, you know, we'll break that up over a couple episodes because that engine does take a long time to put in. So if you're a My Summer Car fan, you can certainly subscribe and turn on the notifications and look forward to that My Summer Car video. Be sometime early in the week that'll get posted. So I think that'll be the plan. Alright, let's see if we're going to get moving here. This video is getting a little long. There we go. Now we can get going. No one's coming there. This guy is going to let us go. Just barely. Nice, buddy. Nice. Alright, red light here. These brakes are definitely touchy. Very, very touchy. Here we go. Make this corner nice and wide because we got a car sitting right there. Perfect. Looks like we're up here on the left. Let's see where he's going to want to place it. Alright, what do you got? Where do you need it? Oh yeah, that's going to be a fun one. Nah, that one's too easy. Well, if we're going to do it, we're going to do it. Yeah, this is going to be interesting. Hope we can swing it. Oh, just made that. Alright. Let's get up on the curb over here. Hopefully no one comes out the door of the shop. We'll slam them back in between the door and the wall. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna make that. No, we are not. So by the looks of it, we're going to have to do a much better swing, or we can just go and back it in over there. But now the tricky part is trying to get traffic to stop for us. Which I doubt we'll be able to do again. Is going to stop for me. Looks like they're going to try. think we're just getting pure lucky right now. We'll go up on the curb. I hope there's nothing over here. Nope, just the buildings over there a little bit. Alright, let's get, let's get out, take a look at it. Okay, so we're almost at the back. We can go ahead and turn to the right up there, straighten her out a little bit. It'll take a couple fixes. We gotta deal with traffic, trying to be quick. There's nothing worse than sitting there waiting for a tractor trailer trying to back into a spot and hold everybody up. So we'll go ahead and... Well, I thought he was going to stop seeing that we were coming, but I guess not. Okay, so... Let's go ahead and crank her around. Nope, what we hit? Oh, we got over there. Let's go ahead and try this again. Now there's no traffic coming. Now we can properly set up. This is what we needed to do from the first place. Oh, I missed it. We went into neutral there. So let's go ahead and let's get this thing all set up. Just missed the pole. Go ahead and straighten her out a little bit. Alright, stop right there. Oh, sorry, buddy. Brushed your trash can a little bit. What are you doing over there, buddy? This guy is asking to get hit. He did not give us any room. I don't think he might have given us just enough room. At least everyone finally decided to give us some space. Let's go ahead and straighten it out a little bit. Now you can go around us, that's cool. Alright, this guy's gonna... Well, go ahead now. No, please, go ahead. Come on. Alright, it's the last one. Now, let's straighten her out. We'll be good. Promise, all the next deliveries will be much smoother than this. This is not really a good one to start off with. it out, we'll see if it likes it. Perfect. Works for me. Miles, 14 hours, 40 minutes, and it only did 28.4 gallons of fuel. Bonus for parking the trailer, hazard class 3 because of the diesel. Level 18, $6,900. Skills. Let's go ahead and do another long distance. Alright, well, that'll do it for this episode. I guess we will try the My Summer Car in the next episode. Not sure when the next one will be for American Truck Simulator. I try to do, you know, episodes every 2 to 3 days, maybe sooner, depending on how they do. I'm just going to try to see whatever, you know, sparks everyone's interest, and we'll take them from there. So, hope everyone has a good weekend, and I'll see you next time.